Hi, I'm Rick with TGW.com. In this video, I'm reviewing 12 of TGW.com's most popular premium golf balls. I hit three distinctively different shots with each golf ball. I'm going to go over the shot data that I saw with each ball in an effort to help you pick the right ball for your game. In alphabetical order by the manufacturer, I hit two of the Bridgestone golf balls. I hit the Tour B RX and the Bridgestone Tour B X. I hit three of the Callaway golf balls, the Chrome Tour X, the Chrome Tour, and the Chrome Soft. I hit two Srixon golf balls. I hit the Srixon Z-Star and the Srixon Z-Star XV. Two of the TaylorMades. I hit the TaylorMade TP5 and the TP5X. And then three of the Titleist products with the Pro V1, the Pro V1X, and the AVX. I hit three different clubs with each of the golf balls, hit many shots. I hit my 56 degree wedge with a full swing. I hit my 30 degree 7-iron and my 9 degree driver. So to dive right in, starting with my 56 degree wedge, I'm swinging at 80 to 81 miles an hour with a negative 4 to negative 5 degree descent angle into the golf ball. The important things, I think, with the wedge are going to be the launch angle, the overall trajectory, and then of course the spin rate. All of these golf balls are premium golf balls, so they all provided excellent stopping power. But starting with spin, the ball that gave me the most spin off of my full swing was the Callaway Chrome Tour X at just under 1,100 RPMs of spin. At a close second were the Callaway Chrome Tour and the Titleist Pro V1X, both at about 10,500 RPMs. If you're a player that's looking for a little bit less spin with your short game, the two balls that gave me the least amount of spin were the Callaway Chrome Soft and the Srixon Z-Star, both at about 9,800 RPMs of spin. And then the Bridgestone Tour B RX at just right at 10,000 RPMs of spin. So my variance went from 9,800 RPMs of spin all the way up to almost 11,000 RPMs of spin. Initial trajectory, I was launching all of these golf balls between 30 and 32 degrees. The TaylorMade TP5 gave me the overall highest trajectory at 76 feet, followed by the Callaway Chrome Soft at 74 feet, and the Bridgestone Tour BX at 73 feet. The lowest trajectory was achieved by the Titleist Pro V1X at 63 feet, the Callaway Chrome Tour X at 66 feet, and then the Callaway Chrome Soft at 73 feet. Altogether, I saw a 13-foot variance from the lowest trajectory to the highest. Moving on to my 30-degree 7-iron, I was swinging at 84 miles an hour on average with approximately a negative 4-degree attack angle. The three balls that gave me the highest ball speed off of my 7-iron were the Srixon Z-Star, the TaylorMade TP5, and the Titleist AVX, all just under 115 miles an hour. My ball speed varied from only 112 to 115 amongst all 12 golf balls. Backspin is very important, not only to give you the right trajectory, but also the appropriate landing angle into the green. I saw about an 800 RPM variance from the least spinning golf ball to the most spinning golf ball. The two balls that gave me the highest amount of spin were the Titleist Pro V1X and the Bridgestone Tour BX, both at about 5,800 RPMs of spin, followed by the Callaway Chrome Tour X at 5,700 RPMs of spin. If you're a player that wants a flatter trajectory, a shallower landing angle, the Bridgestone Tour B RX, the Callaway Chrome Soft, and the Callaway Chrome Tour all gave me spin rates at 5,000 to 5,100 RPMs of spin. Four golf balls gave me the highest trajectory. They were the Titleist AVX, the Titleist Pro V1, and the Titleist Pro V1X, and the TaylorMade TP5X. They all flew at about 95 feet maximum elevation. The two balls that gave me the lowest trajectory were the Bridgestone Tour BX and the Srixon Z-Star, both at about 85 feet. Descent angle, again, is very important when holding the green. If you're a player that needs a steeper descent angle, the Titleist Pro V1X gave me the steepest descent angle at about 47 degrees. I had three golf balls at 46 degrees. They were the Titleist AVX, the Titleist Pro V1, and the TaylorMade TP5X. If you're a player that wants a shallower descent angle, the Callaway Chrome Tour, the Srixon Z-Star, and the Bridgestone Tour BX all gave me a descent angle of 44 degrees. And then carry distance. The golf ball that gave me the longest average carry distance with my 7-iron was the Bridgestone Tour B RX at 167 yards, followed by the Titleist AVX and the Strixon Z-Star, both at 166 yards. And last but not least is the driver. Again, I was hitting a 9-degree driver. Today, I was swinging this club right at 100 miles an hour with a positive 3-4 ascending attack angle into the golf ball. The four golf balls that gave me the highest ball speed were, number one, the Callaway Chrome Tour X at 146 miles an hour on average, followed closely by the TaylorMade TP5, TaylorMade TP5X, and the Bridgestone Tour BX, all at 144 to 145 miles an hour on average. The three balls that launched the highest for me with my driver were the TaylorMade TP5X, the Strixon Z-Star XV, and the Callaway Chrome Soft, all right at about 16 degrees. The lowest launching golf ball for me was the Callaway Chrome Tour X at 12.4 degrees, followed by the Titleist Pro V1 and the Pro V1X at 12 and 13 degrees. Trajectory or peak height on my shots. The three balls that I hit with the highest trajectory were the TaylorMade TP5X, the Callaway Chrome Soft, and the Bridgestone Tour BX. At 120, 115, and 114 feet maximum elevation. The three balls that gave me the lowest trajectory were the Titleist Pro V1, the Titleist AVX, and the Callaway Chrome Tour X at 82, 87, and 88 feet maximum height. Descent angle is important for maximizing the distance and rollout on the end of your shots with your driver. The three balls that gave me the shallowest descent angle were the Titleist Pro V1, the Titleist AVX, and the Callaway Chrome Tour X at 37 and 38 degrees. The three balls that gave me the steepest descent angle were the Callaway Chrome Soft, the TaylorMade TP5X, and the Bridgestone Tour BX, all at 42 degrees. And then total distance. For me, the two balls that gave me the most maximum distance on my drives were the Callaway Chrome Tour and the TaylorMade TP5X. I was averaging 267 yards total distance with those drives, followed closely by the Callaway Chrome Soft and the Callaway Chrome Tour X at 263 yards average total distance. And one final factor that is very important to players, and you may not realize it, is simply the feel of the golf ball. And I've ranked these balls in three categories based on what I felt when hitting them, starting with the three softest feeling golf balls. To me, it was the Titleist AVX, the Callaway Chrome Soft, as the name would state, and the Strixon Z-Star. Contrary, if you like the feel of a firmer golf ball, one that tends to click as it comes off the club face, the three balls that I felt like were the firmest were the Titleist Pro V1X, the Callaway Chrome Tour X, and the TaylorMade TP5X. The other six balls in my mind felt somewhere in between or kind of in a medium feel. I hope all of this data helps you when selecting the right golf ball to fine-tune your game. After reviewing all the data for my own personal game, I think the golf ball I would pick, while all of them are very playable, would be the Callaway Chrome Tour. I like it for its total distance off the driver. Gave me very appropriate launch and spin rate. Off of the 7-iron, it gave me a medium trajectory with an appropriate landing angle, but at a lower spin rate. And I feel like the wind is going to affect that shot a little bit less and help me play better in windy conditions. And then same thing with the wedge. It gave me kind of a medium trajectory and a very appropriate landing angle, but with a very high spin rate. So I know I'm going to get excellent greenside control with that golf ball. And it provided a medium feel, which I really prefer. These are TGW.com's 12 most popular premium golf balls for 2024. Check them out. Please check out our other product review videos at TGW.com.